What's going on, everybody? It is so hot out here in Florida. Y'all know how it is. Today I'm gonna show y'all how to take a nail out your tire and plug it. Right, see, y'all see my tire's going flat. And if you can see real close, there's a nail right there. So I'm gonna show y'all how to plug if y'all have a nail in your tire. Because if you can see, the tread on my tire is good. So I'm gonna show y'all just in case you're not a female and you take it to the tire shop and they tell you the thing has to be replaced. But really all they have to do is plug it or patch it. And a lot of tire shops patch now, but I'm gonna show you how to plug it. And it's real simple. You have a few plug tools. You have this one here that has the grit on it, and that is to like really scoop in to get it good enough. And then you have this one, and this is the one to take the wax and put it in there so that you can tie it, so that you can spin it and you can make a good plug on it. And this right here is the plug. It's like a little rubber wax. Now you can get this real cheap. You can get it from Walmart, AutoZone discount. You can get it from the dollar store. And they work and they're real cheap. So, and today we're gonna use this number right here because that's what we're gonna use to get that nail out. To get that screw out. But it's real easy to do. All you have to do is take this. Take this little black part and we're going to put it between here. So all you have to do is take that and dig that in between there. And it should come through the other side, and then you can just pull it. Then you can just pull it, and that's what you want right there. You want it to look like a T. That's what you want right there. So we're gonna let that sit for a moment. And now we're gonna come here and see what we can do about this plug. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna unhook this plug. I can hear the air coming out right now as we going. I can hear the air coming out. So I just took the nail out. Now I have to make a bigger hole with this grit right here. So I got to go in. Oh, sorry y'all, I might have to, I don't know if y'all gonna be able to see this one, cause hold on, y'all might. Let me see if I can switch the camera around a little bit. See if I can switch the camera around a little bit. See if y'all will be able to see. Oh yeah, y'all can see. So I have to go in and I have to really dig in to get a good hole so I can put the plug in. So I have to really dig in. And really dig. Okay, that's it. We in there. We in there like swimwear. Okay, now I got to come out. Y'all can hear the air coming. Now I got to plug this in, and this is the hard one. Actually trying to get that in, you might need some muscle, but you can get it in. Yeah, you definitely might need some muscle, but you can get it in there. Woo! Yeah, you can get it in there. Woo! There we go. Oh, there we go. All right, plugged up, y'all. Now I'm gonna have to put some air in it. All the air went out. Let's see what happens. So, as y'all can see now, I got my air pump. I always have one of those. You'll need it. And it's going in. And if you ever want to know how much air you have to put in your tires, it says it right here. But now this is size of the tire, 215, 17 rim. I mean 60, R16. R16 stands for the rim. And the PSI is right here, 51 PSI. And PSI stands for pounds per square inch. And that's what you know how much to put in there, to put it back. And you do that and you're good to go. So that's how you plug a tire. And getting it in there, sometimes you gotta use a little muscle. But that's how you do it, man. Thank y'all for watching. Please subscribe for more, and peace.
I hope you guys liked the video. Subscribe, like, and comment. Love you guys.